Hi, welcome to GeeksforGeeks. In a previous video, we discussed the two main properties of dynamic programming problems, namely the optimal substructure property and the overlapping subproblems property. And we also briefly discussed two techniques to attempt dynamic programming problems, namely the memoization technique and the tabulation technique. In this video, we will discuss the memoization technique in more detail. So, the memoization technique is similar to the recursive solution that we discussed earlier. The difference is, in memoization, we maintain a lookup table where we store solutions to the subproblems that we have previously solved. So, instead of solving the same subproblems multiple times, we solve them once and store the answers for reuse later. We first initialize all the elements of the lookup table to a nil value, say -1. Next, we call the recursive function fn that performs memoization for us. At every step fi first looks into the lookup table to check whether a solution is stored there. If a solution is stored, that is table I is not nil, fi returns table I. If a solution is not stored, fi checks whether I satisfies the base condition. If it does satisfy the base condition, we update the lookup table with the base value and return the same. However, if I does not satisfy the base condition, then fi splits the problem I into subproblems and recursively calls itself to solve them. After the recursive calls return, fi combines the solutions to subproblems, updates the lookup table, and returns the solution for problem I. Let us see how memoization will work for our Fibonacci number problem that we discussed earlier. First, we initialize all the entries in the lookup table as nil. Next, we call fib5, but table 5 is nil and 5 does not satisfy the base condition. So, fib5 splits the problem and calls fib4. Now, control moves to fib4, but again, table 4 is nil and 4 does not satisfy the base condition either. So, fib4 2 splits the problem. This goes on until we reach the base condition fib1. Now, fib1 updates table 1 with 1 and returns 1. Then control goes back to fib2, which in turn calls fib0. And similar to fib1, fib0 updates table 0 with 0 and returns 0. And once again, control moves back to fib2. Which now combines the solutions of fib1 and fib0 and stores the result in table 2. Now control moves back to fib3, which in turn calls fib1. However, this time table 1 is not nil, so fib1 simply returns the value stored there. Consequently, fib3 combines the solution to fib2 and fib1 and stores the result in table 3. Now we move up to fib4, which calls fib2. Since table 2 is not nil, fib2 simply returns the value stored there. As a result, fib4 updates table 4. Here, we see that we did not recompute fib2 and hence avoided calls to fib1 and fib0. Next, control moves up to fib5, which now calls fib3. Since table 3 is not nil, fib3 simply returns table 3. And finally, fib5 updates table 5. And thus we see memoization helped us avoid recomputing this entire subtree. Since we solve each problem exactly once, the time complexity of this technique is bigger of n. And since we use a lookup table of size n, the space complexity is bigger of n as well. Let's now move to the C code. This is our lookup table. And in this method, we initialize all the values of the lookup table as nil. And here we have the memoization-based solution to the Fibonacci number problem. We begin with checking whether an entry in the lookup table exists. If it does not, we check whether n satisfies the base condition. If n does satisfy the base condition, we update the table. If n does not satisfy the base condition, we split the problem into subproblems and solve them recursively. And finally, we return lookup n, which is the required value. That will be all for now. Your comments and feedback are welcome. Please do write to us.